morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Mrs. Watson.
I brought my alligator, and he's going to point to the letters, and we're going to say their names. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? What does alligator start with?
A.
So I'll be putting up letter A onto our caterpillar. Now he's growing longer. Now we know capital L and T and F and H and D and I and J and A. And let's go over how we form letter A. Slide down, slide down, connect. Like, and the little A is an apple and a tail. On the side, you make the tail. So we're gonna sing a song today, and it is an ant song. And we're gonna pretend like we're marching. So from your seats, we'll all act like we're marching like little ants. A story. Let me get it out. This story is called 100 Hungry Ants by Eleanor J. Penzias. A whole hill of hungry ants, that's where they live, with faces all aglow, came swarming from the forest to cross the fields below. A soft breeze fanned the sunshine and whisked them on their way. They smelled the yummies. That means a picnic, hooray! 100 ants were singing and marching in one row. We're going to a picnic, a hay and a hidey-ho. Stop, said the littlest ant, we're going way too slow. Some of the food will long be gone unless we hurry up. So, I got a good idea. With two lines of 50, we'll get there soon, I know. All the ants raced here and there, up, down, to and fro. There better be yummies for our hungry tummies, a hay and a hidey-ho. 100 ants were singing and marching in two rows. We're going to a picnic, a hay and a hidey-ho. There goes the pickle and the sandwich and the grapes. Stop, said the little ants. We're going way too slow. Some of the food is already gone. We have to hurry up. So I got another idea. With four lines of 25, we'll get there soon, I know. All the ants raced here and there, up, down, to and fro. There better be yummies for our hungry tummies, a hay and a hidey-ho. 100 ants were singing and marching in four rows. We're going to a picnic, a hay and a hidey-ho. There goes the hamburger, the watermelon, crackers and cheese. Stop, said the littlest ant. We're moving way too slow. Some of the food is already gone. We have to hurry up. So I got another good idea.
That's too much idea.
Five lines of 20. We'll get there soon, I know. All the ants raced here and there, up, down, to and fro. There better be yummies for our hungry tummies, a hay and a hidey-ho. 100 ants were singing and marching in five rows. We're going to a picnic, a hay and a hidey-ho. There goes the donut, hot dog, cookies, apple. Uh-oh. Stop, said the littlest ant. We're going way too slow. Some of the food is already gone. We have to hurry up. So I got another good idea. With 10 lines of 10, we'll get there soon, I know. All the ants raced here and there, up, down, to and fro. There better be yummies for our hungry tummies, a hay and a hidey-ho. 100 ants were singing and marching in 10 rows. At last we're at the picnic, a hey and a heidi ho. There goes the turtle with the cake and the snail with the strawberry. Are turtles and snails, do they move fast or slow? Are they slow or fast? Slow. They're slow. So if a turtle beats you or a snail beats you to the picnic, does that mean the ants are slow or fast? If you're slower than a turtle, are you slow or are you fast? What do you think? If they beat you, then and they're slower than a turtle, is that good or bad? Not very good, huh? Stop, said the littlest ant. We traveled way too slow. Now there's no food for us to eat. You took too long with Rose. All the ants raced here and there, up, down, to and fro. There are any yummies for our grumbling tummies. A hey and a hi dee ho. Oh, no. 99 ants were swarming from each and every row in hot pursuit of the littlest ant, who quickly turned to go. It's not my fault, you know. It's not my fault. But is it his fault?
Yeah.
Whose idea was it to keep lining up and lining up and lining up? Was it a good idea or a bad idea? Yeah, that wasn't the best idea, was it? Well, I brought my little A ant. He's kind of tiny, but I want to show you him. He has his little antennas to talk with, and he likes to go to food and picnics too, but I'm gonna hide him somewhere. And we're gonna play a game of I Spy with my little eye, and I'll give you some clues about where he's hiding, but you have to listen to the clues first. So can I have Pai Pai, Kehlani, and Oakley go in the back by the refrigerator, and I'm going to tell you where I'm going to hide this little A ant. This is a hard one, because I'm going to hide him right here. And he's black, and the computer's black. But we'll see if they can find him. Okay, I spy with my little eye. Come over here so I can tell you. Our A ant, and he's by the C computer where you do your games. C for computer. Oh, you did find him. I thought that was going to be hard. He found him. All right, Mahina, Packer, and Thea, go hide your eyes. Let's see. Let's hide him somewhere a little bit. Oh, let's do the Play-Doh. All right, I spy with my little eye our A ant. And he's next to something that starts with P. And it's something that you play with in the morning with your hands. And you can make little snakes with it. It's Play-Doh. Where's the Play-Doh at? Oh, there's the Play-Doh. There's our aunt hiding the Play-Doh. Very good job. All right. I have, put him back, a story that I'd like to read, like to tell you. Once upon a time, Andy and Ann were twins. They were born on the same day, just minutes apart. They celebrated their birthday A for April, April 1st. And Andy and Ann were excited to get a present for their birthday. When they opened it up, ta-da, an axe. They each got one and couldn't wait to try it out. Andy and Ann went walking deep in the forest to find the perfect tree to cut down with their new little axes. As they were walking, they saw a line of ants. And they seemed to be pointing and acting very strange, like, ah, 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 and their antenna was pointing that way. And he said, something's really scaring these ants. They seem to be pointing this direction, so let's follow the ants. So they followed the ants deep in the forest, and the ants led them to a strange house that looked like a letter A, an A-frame house. All of a sudden, an old lady came out holding a basket of bright red apples. She had an alligator tied to a leash behind her. Hello, said the lady. I'm your Auntie Apple. Do you remember me and my pet alligator? Andy and Ann both shook their heads. No, I don't remember her. They had no idea who this lady was, but she was definitely not their auntie.
Not at all.
Here, said the Auntie Apple. Here's an apple. Here, bite it, eat it. Andy and Ann shook their heads. No, they knew they should never take food from a stranger, and this old lady was definitely not their auntie. In fact, she looked like the old witchy lady from Snow White who carried a basket of poison apples around. Andy and Ann threw their apples down the ground. The alligator crawled over to one of the apples and started to eat it up. No, said the lady, don't eat it, it's poison. The alligator started rolling on the ground in pain. Andy and Ann both ran away as fast as they could. They were glad that they had both refused to eat the apple. They didn't want to end up like Snow White or her poor alligator. What happened to him?
He died.
He ate the poison apple. Did you hear some A things in here?
Apple.
What else?
Alligator?
Ty? Ants, the little ants that they followed. Well, something they got for their birthday.
Axe.
Hey, what was their names?
Andy
and Ann. So I brought some alligators with me. And this one, we're going to be pressing down his teeth and saying A for alligator. If he bites you, I want you to make the A sound. Ah, ah. Let's just pretend, though, if you want to turn. So I'll go to you two first. A. Oh, sorry. A for alligator. Ah, ah, alligator. A for alligator. Ah, ah, alligator. Piper's turn. A for alligator. He likes you. A. That was already done. That was done. A for alligator. Ah, ah, alligator. A for. Ah! Oh, he got Ty. A for alligator. Ah, he got Michaela too. And Mrs. Watson. A. Ah, he got me too. He got me. We're going to sing a song about an alligator. It goes like this. The alligator is my friend. He likes to sing and dance. If only you could understand. Don't wear him as your pants. Alligator, 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 alligator. Can be your friend, can be your friend, can be your friend too. Snap. Can be your friend, can be your friend, can be your friend too. Snap. And we're going to play a little alligator game. And I have some pretend apples. And we're going to be rolling these apples. Says keep away the apples from the alligator. But these alligators are hungry. And they're going to be trying to get the apples. A for apple. Roll that apple. A for apple. Oh, he got one. We're going to keep going. Roll that apple. One. Keep rolling it. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, ten. Oh, they did get the apples. Our alligators didn't go hungry. They got their A apples. All right, I have an object word match. Can I have Thea come hold my apple? Mahina, come hold my alligator up here. Put your hand in here. And I need our friend Oakley to come on up here. Oakley's going to hold my ant. Put it in your hand. All right, I'm going to mix up these words, and we're going to try and match the word to the right object. Ty, can you come up here? Ooh, we got the long one. Let's help everyone help him read this.
Alligator.
Alligator. Where, who should hold that one? The alligator should hold that word. Alligator, alligator. Pie Pie, come pick one. Pie Pie has, what is it? Apple. Apple. Give it to the apple friend. And Michaela, what is this word?
Ant.
Can you give it to the person who's holding the ant? And we're going to learn how to form letter A. This back. So I'm going to have our friends come up here. When you form your letter A, I want you to slide down, connect. But some friends are making this. Is that an A?
Yeah.
At the H, you gotta make sure it's like that A-frame house has to close up. Okay, so we're not making H's. And I'd like you to come up and make a little A too. An apple and a tail. Remember, start on this side. So when you come back, you're in position to make your tail. Wow, look at these beautiful A's. Ty, there's space right here. Thea, you could be right here if you want. Down, down, slide down, connect. I would like to get your ideas now. Raise your hand if you have a favorite A word we can write about. Ooh, okay, I'm gonna draw a nice red apple.
And it tastes yummy.
And it tastes yummy, full of nice vitamins. Everyone say A, P, P, L, and a silent E. Packer?
Alligator.
Ooh, let's draw an alligator. Now, do a lot of alligators eat people or people kill alligators?
People kill alligators.
Yeah, they want to get their bumpy, bumpy skin. Everyone say A, L,
L.
I G A T O R. Alligator. Okay, we got room for one more. Ty.
Axe.
Ooh, that was what they used. They were going to use to chop down the tree. That's the easy one. How do we spell that? A-A-A-X-X-X. What sentence can we use? Maybe use one or two of them.
Tree.
Ooh, axes chops trees, huh? It does. Everyone say, we'll say A.
A.
Two finger space, axe. How do you spell axe? A. A-X. Two finger space, chops. C. Everyone say H.
A.
O.
P.
S. A. Axe, chops, and we're gonna put trees. Everyone say T. R.
E.
E. S. Okay, add period. Tell me when to stop when I get to an A word. How many A's were in there? Axe, chops, trees. When we do our books, we're going to do big A's first. Slide down, connect. Slide down, connect. Slide down, connect. Then we're going to do a row of little A's. An apple and a tail. Round like an apple and a tail. Round like an apple and a tail. And then we're going to do a pattern. Big A, little A. Big A, little A. All right, let's look at our friends and say, let's show them an A with our hands. Everyone show them a big capital A with your hands. A day.
A day.